Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic Carrier's method for the determination of the halogen in organic compound. Hello friends, we know that in organic compound it not only consists of carbon and hydrogen but of different elements also it consists. In the earlier lecture we have studied about the determination of the nitrogen from Dumas method and from Jadal's method, and also we have determined that how can we determine the percentage of the carbon and hydrogen. And now we are going to discuss about how can we determine the percentage or the determination of the halogen atom that has been present in an organic compound. So let us talk about that. So for the determination of the percentage of the halogen atom that has been present in the organic compound, the method that has been known to detect this one is basically known as Carrier's method. So the Carrier's method is the one from which we could be easily estimated that what is the value of, or what is the percentage of the halogen atom that have been present in the organic compound. So for that, let me explain you with the help of this diagram. So therefore, so as to detect the percentage of the halogen atom that has been present in the organic compound, so we have to take this tube, and this is the Carrier's tube that we are talking about. So therefore, it consists of basically the organic compound that has been kept in this capillary, as you could see, with of a known weight. So that organic compound is now being kept in a tube which consists of basically fuming HNO3 as well as the AgNO3 solution. So now, and this whole tube is now being sealed. So therefore, this capillary tube is now being sealed, and we could say that in this case, because of the fuming HNO3 has been present in the tube, so therefore if the carbon and the hydrogen that are been present in the organic compound, so now that would be converted into carbon dioxide or water respectively, and we could see that the halogen atom that has been present in the organic compound, that would be reacted with the AgNO3 so as to form AgX, or we could call it as silver halide. And that silver halide, as we know, because even in this case, because the carbon dioxide and the water that has been produced, so therefore the silver halide, which is not soluble in water when it comes to like silver chloride, silver bromide and silver iodide, so that would be formed in the form of a precipitate. So that precipitate would be collected, and then we could see that it could be again purified, and we could weigh the amount of the silver halide that has been produced. So now that silver halide that has been produced now will be very much easy for us to estimate that what amount of the halogen atom that was being present in the organic compound. So for that we have to do a some kind of calculation, and because we know that the halogens are like fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. But talking about this thing, this method is not applicable for the determination of the fluorine, because fluorine, silver fluorine or silver fluorides are basically the one that are been soluble in water, and that is the reason that we need a precipitate. Or in this case, basically what happens is, even though if we have a organic compound which consists of fluorine, so therefore no kind of precipitation would be formed, and that is the reason that we won't be able to isolate the silver halide when the halogen atom is fluorine. So that is the reason the fluorine atoms cannot be detected by this method. While talking about the another one, that is when it comes to silver chloride, bromide and silver iodide, so they form precipitate, and that precipitate would be very much easy to separate, and hence on we can do an estimation on that how much percentage of the chlorine, bromine and iodine is being present in that. So talking about the first one, that is how can we estimate the percentage of the, that is chlorine atom that has been present in the organic compound. So now we are talking about, we are going to that is determine the percentage of the chlorine that has been present in the organic compound. So let me tell you that the organic compound that consists of the chlorine that will react with silver nitrate, and hence we could get AgX, and that AgX, if it contains AgCl, so now the AgCl that has been now precipitated, so on which we can do the analysis in this form. So in this process we could find the AgCl, because the organic compound will be reacted with the AgNO3 and we have got AgCl, and that AgCl will be precipitated out. But what is the amount of the organic compound, or what is the weight of the organic compound that we have taken? So we have to measure that earlier only. So therefore we could say that is, That is the mass of organic compound, let me consider it as M. And talking about the next one, that is the amount of AgCl that has been produced during the reaction, that is let that be M1. So when talking about AgCl, so once the AgCl has been obtained, so we could be easily determine that how much amount of chlorine has been present, because we know that is 1 mole of AgCl, which is having a weight of basically around 143.5 gram of AgCl. The reason behind that is Ag has, or silver has a that is atomic weight or molar mass of that is 108, and that of the chlorine it has basically 35.5. So overall the molar mass of the AgCl is because 143.5, and from which we could get to know that the amount of the silver that has been present in the 143.5 HCl is basically 108, and that of the Cl is basically 35.5. so by this calculation we could easily determine that what is the amount of the chlorine that has been present in the this much amount of weight that we have got. So we could easily write it as, that is therefore 143.5 gram of AgCl, it consists of basically 35.5 gram of chlorine. So we could say that is the M1 gram that we have got of AgCl. So therefore the M1 gram of AgCl that we have got, that would be equivalent to, we will do a cross multiplication over here like this one, that is 35.5 into M1 the whole divided by 143.5 gram. So therefore this much gram of chlorine has been present, and that is what we could get. But we have to determine the percentage of the chlorine, so therefore it is very much easy to understand, that is the percentage of chlorine will be nothing but the gram that we have got, that is 35.5 into M1 divided by 143 divided by the amount of the organic compound, or the mass of the organic compound, that is nothing but M. And what we have to do is we have to multiply it by 100 so as to get the percentage of the chlorine. So this is how we could determine the percentage of the chlorine that has been present in the organic compound. So similarly we could also estimate the percentage of the bromine. So let me talk about that also. That is when it comes to the 1 mole of, suppose if bromine has been present, so if that would react with the nitric acid that has been present, as well as we could say that is silver nitrate, then we could say that AgBr has been produced. But and this is for, that is determination of bromine, therefore we could say that is 1 mole of AgBr will consist of, that is 188 gram of AgBr. So we could say that among 188 gram of AgBr we could find out the weight of the bromine also. So therefore we could write it as, therefore 188 gram of AgBr will consist of at least 80 gram of bromine. So here also let us consider the mass of the AgBr that has been produced. Earlier we have took it as M1, now we could also take it as M2 suppose in that case. So therefore we could say that is, if M2 gram of AgBr will produce, that is we will do a cross multiplication in this case, that is 80 into M2 divided by 188 gram of bromine. So whenever it comes to the percentage, then how can we determine the percentage? It is very much easier to understand, that is percentage of the bromine that has been present in the organic compound can be written as this much amount of bromine that was been present. So therefore 80 into M2 divided by 188 into, that is the amount of the organic compound, and that is suppose m and we have to multiply it by 100 so as to get the percentage of the bromine atom or percentage of the bromine. So therefore this is how we could estimate the percentage of bromine. And similar to that of the, we could also find out the percentage of iodine that has been present in the silver iodide. So therefore let us consider that also. So therefore we could write it as in this way, that is for the determination of iodine. So now in this case we could easily determine that the what would be the weight of the AgI, but for which we know that is 1 mole of AgI is nothing but it consists of that is the weight of the AgI, it is nothing but 235. So therefore 235 gram of AgI, that is what we could get. So now if we compare this thing, then we could know, get to know that is since 235 gram of AgI or silver iodide consists of basically 127 gram of iodine, therefore we could say that is the mass of the AgI, suppose let it what we have got it as suppose m3. So therefore say m3 gram of AgI will consist of how many grams of iodine. So that is what we could do. We will do a cross multiplication like this one, that is 127 multiplied by m3 into that is 235. Now this one would be basically the gram of iodine that we could get. But if we have to determine the percentage of the iodine, so therefore it is very much easy, that is percentage of iodine can be written as that is 127 into m3 the whole divided by 275 into that is m. This m is the amount of the organic compound that we have to, and that should be multiplied by the 100. So now this is how we could get the percentage of the iodine. So this was a very easy method to determine that what would be the percentage of the halides or halogens in the organic compound that has been present. So therefore this was the method, and that was been applicable because of the curious method that we have did, and this is what I want to talk about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know that an idea, that is how can we determine the percentage of the halogen atom that has been present in the organic compound. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to EKEDA channel. Thank you so much.